So the first part of the stream going to be like live learning, but it's not really live learning, right? Because live learning, I'm doing stuff like for the first time, or not the first time, but I'm kind of listening to it and playing simultaneously. I'll sort of do that too, but this is more like I would learn a song when I would prepare something for YouTube. Someone to kind of share how that process, whatever, looks like. So that's what we're going to be doing now. But before I started, I thought I'd try to play the song as like from memory, because I did listen to it like a bunch of times so far. So this very, very first time, I'm going to play like the song as I remember it. I'm not listening to it now. I've listened to it maybe like 7 times, like since it came out, right? And so I'm kind of remembering it. But this is like my before. Okay, so we'll do that once. Okay, let's see. I also mute myself for this. Something like that. I don't remember how long that intro is. Something like that. Also, Sam, thank you so much for subscribing. Okay? Let me start from scratch. This is like a weird balance, right? Because I want to interact with everybody, but I also want to do like this clean first take. So this is me. Okay, no, I think this part has like this already. Okay. Okay, so this is... Honest, this is like the first time I've ever tried to play the song like on a piano, right? Because I listened to it like when I was abroad, no piano there, and I got back and all I did was like setting up. So this is like my first ever time playing it like from the way I remember it. Okay, so we have the before, which probably one piano in Madrid, maybe. But okay, so now we're going to try to do what I usually do when I learn a song, which is just like kind of breaking it down and listening to it and analyzing it and kind of like figuring it out. So hopefully this part will also be good. Although I have to say, like, okay, not to toot my own horn, and I know we have a toot command on the stream. Okay, I will toot my own horn. Fuck it. That first version, not bad, okay? This wasn't so bad. It's not like kind of, it wasn't so far off. It wasn't precise, you know? Like, it couldn't really, like, be. It's not the exact melody. There's a lot of nuances, and that's the part I want to go into. Okay, so are you ready? We're going to go to lab mode. Yes, I will put the song back together, Sam, after I break it down. So let's see if lab mode works for us. I'm excited. All right, here's lab mode. Hello. Hi, lab. Welcome to my not so evil lab. Okay, so what do we have? So I thought what I'll do is, like, I have a way to, like, listen to the song, like YouTube, which means, like, this whole VOD might get muted. I don't know really if it works or not. Second, on the right hand side, we have the lyrics of the song, which I copied before. And on the left corner, well, there, way over there, that's just like another shot of the piano so you can see my hands. And, my hands. And some other mess, but mostly my hands. Okay. And just to prove, see, this is me. Hands doing this thing in the both side. Okay, it's not pre-recorded. I know everybody's sure I'm cheating all the time and everything is like pre-made and pre-recorded. No, I swear. I wish I had like today's newspaper, but I don't. I don't have tomorrow's newspaper either. Right, so let me know if the balance is kind of okay, because I need to, like, actually play the song. So let's see. Is it too loud for you folks? I don't know if it's too loud. Definitely a lot of breathing. Tell me if the volume is, like, reasonable, because this is what I kind of need to be playing with. Right, so I can kind of like go into the lyrics. Now, this is what I do when I actually have to learn a song for like recording it or like playing it in a live show with somebody, but I don't really do it that often anymore. I've been doing live learns for a while on stream, so I didn't have to do like anything similar to this. But this is how it usually would look like. I'm kind of like getting all the lyrics on screen in one place. And I usually kind of break them down like into whatever makes sense to me. Now, like, because the song is already familiar, I'm not sure if I need to like write down every little part of it, but like stuff that I want to not forget when I play from this list, so I would do something like, okay, let's see what the intro is, right? So I kind of remember how many beats it is. I have this E. Okay, now usually, okay, now this is where it gets like into the in-depth part, right? When I was listening to the song all these times, I knew that there's like something like, something like that. Now I'm listening carefully and I see that A, first of all, the chords are like these specific ones. This is the bass. And the second thing I can hear is there's a little like very high note. Just like matched with these chords. Let's listen to it again. Here we can hear it. It's like a violin. Okay. So what I usually would, the way I would write it, I would do something like lowercase to kind of signify that it's a different thing. So technically, if I would need to actually read it, you know what, maybe, I don't know if it's like large enough. Let's make it a little larger. I don't know if I can do that. Bah. Okay, so technically the way I would read it, it would be like, and I can feel I'm already losing everybody, okay? So I don't care. I'm still going to try to do it. And hey, folks, I love you guys. I thank you so much for being here for stuff. This is like an experiment. But if you don't feel like watching me like do one line per hour, which I hopefully it will be faster than that. But just feel free to come back later when we're doing the actual request stuff. Enough apologizing. Okay, so technically, like if I had to read it, that would just like I'm supposed to remember like this, like l not lowercase is like the bass, E, C, and AM. But you know, like, but mostly I'm memorizing it by writing it down. And then it, like she starts singing, and actually there's a little like effect I hear, like it kind of goes into, but we won't be doing that because we're not doing like a full production, just the piano version. Here they are, those notes again. Okay, now what I want to do is like, first of all, I'm going to just like follow the melody, or as Goddess would say, follow the vocals. I just want to see if I kind of remember intuitively the way she sings. Because I have this like one melody in my mind, but then there's like all these nuances. Okay, this first phrase is pretty straightforward. I mean, it's the way I remember it. The only thing that is special here is that A, it doesn't change at all, like the way she sings the first, like. That's like the second special thing, that there's a little pause before the never say good bye. Let's see it again. People walk away. I sort in. Write out my symphony, play with me, look into my eyes and see. People walk away, but never say goodbye. And there's like an echo on the goodbye, bye. Okay. Let's do the second line and then see how, if I need to remember something. You know what? Like, I'll just do the good bye bye. So kind of making the lyrics match the way the melody works. Hey, asshat. Great.
Walk away and play with me. Write out my symphony, play with me, look into my eyes and see. People walk away, but never say goodbye.
Second line.
Someone stole the moon tonight, took my light. Everything is black and white. Who's the fool who told you boys don't cry?
Okay, so once again, there's stuff going on in the background, which I will need to address in a moment, but for now, like the second line sounds exactly like the first. Like, I mean, she's keeping it very simple. There's no like decorations, no kind of up and downs, like beyond what she did in the first one, which is important because, like, one mistake I would often do is like if I remember something cool that somebody does in a song, I'd always remember that they only did it like in verse two or the last chorus. So I end up kind of playing it like all over the place. But if you want to be like really exact, then you want to know exactly when it's coming. Okay. And again, the same pause. So the moon tonight, took my light. Everything is black and white. Who's the fool who told you boys don't cry? Okay, even more like slowed down on this cry. But, you know, I think it will be forgivable if it's not like super precise. I'm going to leave this space for now. Okay, now let's do the second interesting thing, which is what's actually going on in the music beyond her singing. Because her singing, I think I got. Let's see. There's actually interesting things going on there with the piano, especially on the second part. Writer of my symphony, play with me, look into my eyes and see. People walk away but never say goodbye. Okay, so what I hear is like the piano is like playing the bass chords mostly. I think so, let's try it again. Writer of my symphony, play with me, look into my eyes and see. People walk away but never say goodbye. Okay, so the first one, and then there's like kind of like a little decoration with the piano. Okay, once again. Writer of my symphony, play with me, look into my eyes and see. People walk away but never say goodbye. Okay, one thing I kind of not sure, I want to hear exactly how that decoration sounds like. Symphony, play with me. Writer of my symphony, play with me. Writer of my symphony, play with me. It almost sounds like it's not like, it's only like the chord is happening. So I need to also play like together, right? So let's see. Now this is like the part that usually Sam is excited about, the combination of hands. Again. So I have a choice, like I need to play the vocal melody, which is like, but like I know the piano is doing like this at the same time. So if I play it like around the same area as I play the vocals, it will kind of sound like she's singing that. Not sure I want to do that. So what I would do is maybe play that like a little lower on this part. And now I need to figure out the second part. Look into my eyes and see. Hi, goddess. Walk away, but never say goodbye. Say hello to people in the chat. Someone stole the moon tonight, took my light. Even more decoration, right? Because this was like, this was like everything this. Everything is black and white. Who's the fool who told you boys don't cry? Okay, now it's the same structure. The only difference is like the first line had this like very subtle, and this one has it more notes in it. I think it was this. Fool who told this. Took my light. Someone stole the moon tonight, took my light. Yeah. Everything is black and white. Who's the fool who told you boys don't cry? Okay, so we have like I think the first part. No, hopefully it will all happen like faster from here on out.
My light, everything is black and white. Who's the fool who told you boys don't cry?
Let's try it with just the vocals now.
Listen to boys
that next
don't
part.
cry.
Oh, you know what?
I was
Actually, that's one thing I want to remember. So this is the way I usually write this stuff down. So like I know this like have this like DB, which basically means D note, B note, which is just a way for me to remember like this part is there. And someone stole the moon tonight, and it will be like da 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 da. And hopefully that will be enough for me to remember it. Another thing I do is kind of write down the chords to kind of remember the vibe. Hopefully I won't forget those chords, right? Because that's like the core of the song. So it's like that repeats. Okay, now let's figure out this hours and hours and powers part. Let's see.
Power cry. Hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes wild.
Okay, so I kind of remembered where it goes intuitively. Let's try it again.
This was don't cry. Hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes wild.
So pretty. I don't think I need to write it down. I mean, not really. I think maybe. No, I don't think there is. I mean, you know, regular studio tuning stuff, but her voice is so pretty. Yeah. What is this song? Yeah, I should be telling people all the time. So, this is the Israeli Eurovision song.
Every day the time goes wild. Every day
Maybe this echo? Maybe, yeah.
hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes wild.
Okay, so
Every day.
one more. Okay, just one thing about this. At first, the piano plays exactly the same notes as the vocal melody, right?
Powers life I hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes
And it
wild.
disappears on the second part, so it's like. I feel this while is a little like shaky when I play it. Let's hear it again.
This hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes
The
wild.
time, because she's not really singing the part. So it kind of less melody, I have to guess it.
Hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours while the time goes wild.
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't be wrong playing like, or doesn't really matter because she does like. The time goes, the time. Okay, now let's listen to the chorus because it's really pretty. I'm going to listen to it without stopping it.
Every day I'm losing my mind.
lot of echo, right?
Dancing in the storm. I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still
a lot of stuff here. Ah, fuck. Okay, this song is so good. Okay, now we have to actually figure out what's going on in that chorus.
I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind.
Okay.
The time goes by.
Let's start with the vocals because they're so pronounced, right?
Every day I'm losing my mind.
I'm already making a mistake. Okay, so, okay, the first part is kind of straightforward. Oh wait, where is my okay, this is the chorus part, so let's listen to it. So it's straightforward in that the vocals are kind of like ta 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 tam. There's no like kind of weird pauses. If I really want to be like, you know, there's like little like small ideas there in the vocals, like I don't know how to call them, like kind of, I say decorations a lot, but that's not what it is. It's kind of like this stylings, I guess, where you kind of decide not to just, you know, kind of slide upwards towards the note or downwards towards the note. So I'm not going to be like super precise on these. Because I'm not like training somebody to sing it.
Dancing in the storm, I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane. This hurricane.
Oh God, so pretty. I'm just not playing the real part on the left hand. Now I'm actually going to look at the lyrics so I can kind of like figure out how they follow this. That feels like weird, like the words take it all and leave the world behind. No. Oh no, it's dancing in the storm, I got nothing to hide, right? Baby. Okay, so I think I got the vocals on this. So pretty this.
Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane.
Just listening to this. Leave the world behind.
Okay.
Okay, now let's do the like kind of what's happening out like in the left side, which means like the actual accompaniment. Now, this is what I would play like if somebody would be like singing along. So I have to like figure this out and then not do it right, because again, I always want to play the vocals like together with the arrangement. Now, this is going to be hard because I need to like ignore her vocals. And her vocals are amazing, so I don't want to ignore them, but I have to kind of pretend that they're not there just to figure out what's going on with the piano.
Time goes wild. Every day I'm losing my mind. Holding on in this mysterious ride.
It's going to be hard because it's like kind of masked, but it's kind of like... Like the beginning is kind of like it kind of like starts as kind of it's going to be like always this, and you know, when the song gets super popular and everybody's doing their covers of it, you're going to probably hear a lot of this. Like if I had to learn the song in 1 minute, I would only play that. But let's figure out what's actually going on there. There's like this part is very interesting.
Every day I'm the time goes wild. Every day I'm losing my mind.
Yeah.
I'm still broken.
Yeah, I won't be able to do it, I swear, because like her vocals are keeping like I'm immediately like floating towards her vocals. I'm just going to try a little more.
Every day, the time goes.
Yeah, you have to ignore those guys spinning around her.
Every day I'm losing my mind. Holding on in this mysterious.
Okay, I feel like that's about like generic. I made a whole speech about how I don't want to be like general about it, but then I can't. I honestly can't.
Every day I'm losing goals.
I'm going to make it a little louder for me, so hold on. Why, and for you. Sorry if it, now you won't be hearing the piano as well.
Every day I'm losing my mind. Mysterious ride, dancing in the storm. I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind.
I think that's kind of it. This part I don't remember.
Mysterious ride.
Huh. It almost doesn't do the like. It doesn't participate in the vocal part as much.
In this mysterious ride. Holding on in this mysterious ride. Dancing.
Hold one last time, I think.
Every day I'm losing my mind. Holding on in this mysterious ride. Dancing in the storm.
No, there is like something going on there with the piano.
It's mysterious, right? Dancing in the storm.
I think it's like something like. No, it's like funny as F sharp, G, F sharp.
Holding on in this mysterious ride, dancing in the storm.
I think. Okay, now I see it. So the accompaniment would be like. Probably in the second time it's different.
I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind. Baby, promise.
Yeah. So the second time is like a. Okay, so just to get the chorus, kind of this part of the chorus, not exactly out of the way, but just like, let's try to play it one more time. Okay. So that was already like me combining them. I keep playing the bass like in a way that I remember it, but I don't think that's really how it works. So now I'm going to listen to the bass a bit.
Every day mysterious ride, dancing in the storm. I got nothing to hide. Take it out and leave the world behind. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again.
Okay, so what I need to remember from this is that actually the I keep wanting to do like kind of really like go all in on this like E, F sharp minor. But no, it's more subtle. So I need to remember to do like. Hold on just a second. Right, so do I need to write everything for this hours and hours? Empowers life in the game as hours. While I think this like while the time goes wild. And I'm just writing it like this so I remember it's like longer. And here's the amazing chorus. So the chords are really simple, deceptingly, deceivingly. Okay, now I can't really be writing down the whole like... even though it's really pretty, but I don't think I'm going to like... It's too difficult to write down what's going on here. So I'm just going to write a hint on this, like, every day I'm losing to my nine, only just right. Dancing in the storm, there's like this F sharp, G, F sharp, which is the clever part, which is like this. Am I playing the fourth note? Yes, yes, I'm okay. So I'm getting a question in chat if I'm playing a question from Squash. If I'm playing the fourth note of that arpeggio with my right hand. So almost always I'm going to be like cheating like this because I'm playing the melody with my right hand, right? But I have these fingers that are free and they're going to be helping me like doing all the difficult parts. Hopefully this like whole chorus part I will remember so I don't have to write every note. But you know, okay, how would a serious pianist would play this part? Because that's like what I always feel like I'm doing it like so differently, right? So usually a serious pianist would like be doing So it's like just I need to be so much more attentive with the jumps, right? And you know, in a way it maybe will sound better, right? Because the dynamics are like it's a bigger range if you play it like you are here on the melody and maybe it's like kind of a limitation that I'm playing it closer. But it's just the way I'm used to play. So that's my trick. I'm still broken from this heart again. Oh, yeah. So one part I haven't played yet is like the left hand on the last part of the chorus. Baby, now here, yeah, here like the important thing, like I will definitely not be able to ignore her vocals because they're so strong and beautiful, Eden. But what can I say? There's okay. So one thing I notice here is like this. There's like this tum, tum, tum. Like the rhythm on the bass. If you listen to it, there's like a bit of a heartbeat going on there. Baby. I'm still broken from this hurricane. Oh, it's so beautiful. Okay, so I don't know if I will even play something so different. Still broken, you're behind. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane. This hurricane. Okay, so probably I can't even do something so interesting like here But I'm going to try, like, you know, to kind of feel the rhythm of it. I'm going to try to do like, so like this part, everything's supposed to disappear at the very end, right? So let's say drop here and make it bold. Yeah, honestly, that's the way I like, that's my arrangements. And then people on YouTube like write to me and say like, hey, can I have the sheet music for that song you played? And I always feel like this is stupid, because like, yes, I'll send you the lyrics with these little like things in them, and you know, good luck. You know, it doesn't really help other people. But I want to share how I do it. Yes, that is bold. Thank you, Sam. I think that's the part where I'm dropping. Where am I? Let's listen that it's correct. I'm surprised the world be. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane. Baby, promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane. This hurricane. That doesn't help if it doesn't help if I just listen. I need to remember when to drop my own song. It's on the cane, so correct. The way I wrote it is correct. Okay, now, last time I listened to it, now I'm hearing there's like some violins going on. All the way up top in the mix. Let's listen to it again. It actually started before. I think they're standing on the behind, they're definitely like flowing louder into the mix. Be promise me you'll hold me again. I'm still broken from this hurricane. There's no way I'm going to like isolate it. I'm still broken from this hurricane. Oh, it's really like, maybe the headphones are not good enough. It's really in there. Hold on. I'm still broken from this hurricane. It sounds like it's doing something like, but that's probably simplifying it. This broken from this hurricane. I'm still broken from this hurricane. Okay, no way. I can't do it. Still broken from. Something around this area, but I won't be able to play it, and it doesn't really matter because I'm like playing her vocals anyway on that part, so you wouldn't know it's there. But I just need to like remember the feeling that it's kind of all overflows there with the emotion. So it's not just the heartbeat, it's not just the vocals, there's also like the violins there, which are going to be completely missing from my version. I guess what I'm doing here is like listening to the song about 20 times. Okay, now the good news, guys, is that we're pretty much at like the we're at the half point, right? It's a Eurovision song, and it means it's like 3 minutes long, and we're at like minute 23, which means now all we know about Western music is like there's going to be another verse, another pre-chorus and chorus for something. Eurovision song, do we even have time for a bridge? Probably not. But you know, I played my initial version of the song already, so. This hurricane. It's so funny, like when I listened to this song originally, I was so into like this, like of course, because that's like the drive of the song. But now I'm hearing this like very, very, very high pitched like violin on top of that too. Just two notes, just E and D. Oh wow, there's a guitar. Okay, now, so okay, this is like a whole thing. Okay, that's, we'll start with the synth sound because that's probably like the most like similar to everything else. This hurricane. Okay, again. It's not even with the G, I'm playing an extra note for no reason. Okay, and now, of course, there's a guitar there, which is really pretty, which I also didn't think about. And it's probably going to be like very, like, kind of basic strumming. Four strings. Okay, it's a little more specific. Let's again. This hurricane. First chord. That's like easy. Oh, and here it gets pretty. Okay, so it's like, no, probably, okay, I think it made it too pretty on the last one. Maybe not, let's see. No, okay. Okay, so it's like, this like could be a whole like bass, you know, basic part of a song, of a really good song too. Okay, so I think like probably this is probably like part of the magic of why this like middle part between the verses is more captivating. I don't yeah, a bit. To me it kind of sounds almost like kind of getting into like Backstreet Boys kind of harmonies. No, let's play with it again. Living in a fan. Okay. Really pretty. This part I probably need to write down something. Guitar, so it'll be AM EM, and then for the third one I'm going to like okay, let's do like this. Little bars sometimes help me to see like these are different parts. So I have um so this kind of helps me remember that, like, you know, like AM is like whatever, it's like what I expect it to be. Then this would be EM, but it's like I actually have to play these E, G, B, and this is like G with D, A, B. And last one is D with F sharp, G, D. Now, sometimes, like, if I would do it with a pen, I would actually, like, write down, like, little arrows to say that it goes up. You know, hopefully I remember it always goes up here. Bridge. I don't know, it's not exactly a bridge. Let's call it not intro, not the outro. What do you call something that is just like there? pre-verse. Interlude. Yeah, that's not good. That's very good. Thank you, Astrocon. Interlude. Vocal would be like just ta 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 ta. Right. And violin, we don't really care about. Let's like pretend we do. So it's like E and D, but we're not going to actually care about it, right? What is middle eight? I'm not sure what middle eight is. I know what is the middle C. It's this, I guess, the note C in the middle of the piano. That part I know. Okay, so now we're definitely halfway through. Because we had the second verse. Good as the first. But, okay, this is a good chance to try to play like the beginning again. So let's see if I remember anything. So now I'm remembering this, like those little like E marks, like the small, the lowercase things at the top are the kind of violin. So I have to remember this. And blah, blah, blah. Imagine the breathing sounds. Okay. I'm less insecure. Hold on. I also want to kind of turn it a little bit towards me. I keep feeling like I'm on the wrong side of the camera. The boy on the wrong side of the camera. Okay, let's try it again. So, yes, this is like a good kind of middle of the road point, because I can tell I remember a lot of the things that we cracked, but not all of them. So I kind of, some of them I remembered just a second afterwards. And hello, Saminari, and other people in the chat. Thank you. I'm sorry I'm not showing the chat on screen this time. I just like wanted to get through the live learn, not live, just learn of the song. Okay. So what I learned from playing this the first time is that I'm going to have some trouble remembering parts of it, but most of it is there. I forgot doing like the heartbeat on the last part of the chorus. And I forget to do the correct like guitar notes on the... But close enough. Okay, let's see what's happening in the second verse, which I remember is like there's more things going on with like the actual rhythm and the beats, which will not be a good thing for my arrangement because most of it is like completely like absent from what I'm doing. But let's see. Ecstasy, living in a fantasy. Ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will never die. Hours. Okay, so second verse is shortened. She's getting to the hours and hours like faster. Okay, let's do just the vocal part first. Living in a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will never die. Hours. Okay, it's short. Love will never die. Die. So she's actually doing like a reverse on that. Die, which you can say like maybe is a dip if you want to go deep into like how the composer. I should probably give some credit. Wait, who composed it? Fuck, I didn't write it down. Hold on. Oh, maybe somebody in my chat can check out like who's like the lyricist and composer. I remember Karen Pellis, but not the other people. Fuck. Okay. So the thing I want to remember here is that in Ecstasy, okay, Avi Ohayon, Karen Pellis, and Stav Beger wrote this song. So kudos, it's one of my favorite songs. So thank you. So Ecstasy, she's doing like, So there's like this, the D is high, baby. So I'm doing kind of like uppercase to remember it, but hopefully I will. We shall pass, but nothing will never die. And this is E, F sharp, and G, kind of the reverse of like. And again, there's a little delay before the die part. Pass by living in a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will never die. Okay, now there's another little thing with the vocals here. Exactly after the ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass. It's very subtle, but like after ecstasy, there's like a little like ecstasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will still see. There's a bunch of like kind of reversed vocals there, added on top. Living in a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love. Living in a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will never die. Okay, let's figure out what's going on with the accompaniment there so we can move forward. Living in a fantasy, living in a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but got the mm-hmm.
See, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but love will never die.
So if you want to be super precise, like if I had to arrange the song for other instruments, which I never did in my life, but you can kind of tell that there's a little subtle difference here beyond the beat, which is like boom, boom, very present here.
Be, we shall pass, but love will never die.
The chords that in the first verse, which was like full on ballad mode, were played with the piano. Here, I'm pretty sure it's kind of like a piano and the guitar strumming, maybe, or even just the guitar.
Ecstasy, ecstasy, everything is meant
this part.
To be. We shall pass, but love will never die.
I'm definitely hearing this like. Okay, very nice. And hello to Al Yahudi also in the chat.
Living in a fantasy.
So another interesting thing here is like this, like a
living in a fantasy, ecstasy, every
like this kind of like this like G, like kind of really isolates it for a second. Okay, and I need to kind of connect it together, right? Because it happens with this like have this another hours and hours part. Let's see if it sounds similar enough to everything that came before.
Thing is meant to be, we shall pass, but love will never die. Hours and hours and powers, life is no game, but it's ours.
Okay, this is the part I need to write down. Definitely, right? Because the vocals are going somewhere else.
And hours and powers, life is no game, but it's ours. Hours and hours and powers, life is no game, but it's ours. The time goes wild.
Oh, you know, wait a minute. Let's listen to like the rest of the song. I have to listen to the rest of the song and then we'll go back.
Love will never die. Hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours. Why? The time goes wild. Every day I'm losing my mind.
I can't push her. I'm already hearing amazing stuff.
אפילו אם קשה לראות, תמיד אתה משאיר לי אור אחד קטן.
Oh god, it's so pretty. Okay, so we have to go back, as Jack said in Lost. You know, it's amazing. Already I heard stuff that I haven't heard before.
Was wild. hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours. Why the time goes wild. Every day I'm losing.
Okay, let's break that pre-chorus part.
Goes no game, but hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but hours and hours and powers. Life is
no. Okay, so hours and hours and powers. Now I need to start writing down the different vocal, right? Da na 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 na. Do 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 do. This is like a different part. Do. The time goes and the wild is just an A note, but they're doing something very clever and they're doing this like kind of like the overtones you get like by playing like this magical like string, like something you do in the guitar, which I can't explain. Okay, so it's just like I feel it sounds like this. But it's like a guitar sound, like on a time goes wild.
The time goes wild.
And it's so smart. There's like so many things happening here. There's like this at the end, and which is like a guitar kind of whoosh.
The time goes wild. Every day I'm
Yeah, they're really like putting the step into the stepping into the chorus in a beautiful way.
Where's life is hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but
you know, I should probably have said this before, but in case people are not familiar, like, and I know people comment on this a lot on YouTube, and honestly, some of the comments are a bit like hardcore, too hardcore for me. But this song is very, 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 very rooted in the October 7th attack in Israel, and of course like the huge thing is like this big music festival where people were massacred, and like the video is kind of very much about it. But I guess, okay, another way of looking at it is like once you have like a piece of art like this, there is a way to interpret it as like a personal struggle, and there's a way to interpret it as a national tragedy, and it's just like it works either way. And you could even have like anybody else sing it and it would still work. But the video is like so loaded with like symbolism, and you know, there's something in it. There's something in it that is like really heartbreaking and touching. And because the music festival was like electronic music, so any like little subtle hint towards the sort of scene that it was like that music festival was, it's kind of hidden in between the lines. Like whenever she says like ecstasy, like you kind of have to feel it has to have something to do with like, you know, the drugs, because it's kind of like that sort of event. And and I feel like whenever the music here is like hitting this like very like electronic music vibes, including the drop.
In a fantasy, ecstasy, everything is meant to be. We shall pass, but
not on this part. On this part.
Hours and hours and powers. Life is no game, but it's ours. Why? The time goes wild.
Yeah, I don't know how to explain exactly, but there's something in the arrangement there that makes me feel like it's very specifically referencing this sort of music, this part. I win those poor game, but it's always right. The time goes poor. Obviously, when I'm playing it on the piano, it's different, but it feels like very electronic. Okay, we'll get to this part. Okay, let's just make sure that there's nothing hiding in that last chorus. Okay, how do I write down like the five things going on here? Hours and hours of power life, and then goes wild. And then there's like this overtones magic, whatever. Hold on, can't type. Overtones. How dare you? Is there? Go and listen to the song, and then I think you'll really like it. Oh, you probably did already. We talked about it on the Discord. Every day, okay. Well, the time is a wild overtones. It's like dum, dum, dum. Almost sounds like an elevator announcement or like announcement in a shopping mall. Yeah, dum, dum, dum. So I can't do like everything that happens there. No. See, I need to also remember to do like the tum tum. So probably it won't happen because I can't do all of it together and still have it sound good. Let's see. No, it doesn't sound like a drop when I play too many notes. No. It's like when they say, like, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything. So maybe it's like, if you don't have anything nice to play, don't play anything. Cut off the sustain. Let's see. The problem is like this part, boom boom, is very like, it doesn't work with like melody. Doo-doo. I mean, fuck. Mm. definitely, I don't want to fill the whole thing. I don't want to do like, yeah, you know, actually, if it was like a guitar thing, you would like hit the guitar two more times. I'm going to like give up on the tum tum. In favor of just like kind of a more pronounced go into it. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And as people tell me in the chat and concert, will make that sound. They would do pum pum.
Every day I'm losing my mind, holding on in this mysterious ride, dancing in the storm. I got...
Okay, I'm going to make it a little louder for myself, hopefully. So the vocals I feel like I got already, but I still need to figure out, well, like, is there anything special about the like accompaniment on this part? I feel like there's like something going on, like a... something like is more full there.
Every day.
Okay, so I feel like I'm not going to do anything special with the chorus. Like, it's more kind of straight, repetitive, like they're a little like heavier on the... The vocals are making the most of the, like, driving it forward. And they're already familiar. Behind, I feel like it's kind of distributed differently. I need to remember it's like world behind. So fucking beautiful. I can't get over how great this part is. Okay.
This hurricane.
So many great drops.
This hurricane.
So it's like really... Okay, this is like the stuff that when you do like a one take recording, which is like everything I did for YouTube, it's like really like, oh fuck, it will be like so nerve-wracking to get to that point of the song and then find out that you actually like didn't hit that note. Because here's what's going on. There's like this like pam pam pam, this hurricane, like then, yeah. Okay, so first of all, you have to do like the pam pam pam, make everything disappear in the accompaniment. And this hurricane, second time she sings, is like kind of like with you know, without like anything below it. And then what I'm hearing, so today is the first time I've noticed this part. There's like a bit of like this piano running around. This hurricane. Okay, well, the good news are we're almost done. Okay. Okay. Let's not tempt myself with the piano part. Let's just figure out the vocals are the same as what I expect. It's very high. Oh, this is interesting because she's doing... I've noticed somebody on YouTube like who listened to the song was a reaction, was like also pausing on the vocal parts, and he also noticed this like this hurricane. This hurricane. Not the first time. Huh. That's like the last part, which is in Hebrew. Okay. So, this part, what's the name of this composer? N.O.D., I think. N.O.D., the Italian composer. So, this last, like the piano part, sounds a bit like his stuff. I feel like I've lowered her vocals too much because she's going. No, I keep playing this da 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 instead of just da. Okay. And also, once again, thank you to the people in the chat, which is not on screen today, but I see it and I read it. So hi, Lisha, welcome in. Thank you. Okay, let's see it once again. Okay, so let's see, what do I need to remember on this part? This last hurricane is like, has this like part at the end. World behind, we noticed that it was like world behind, world behind. Hopefully I will remember this. Life is no game. Okay, now I don't think I can even play like Just like, it's so pretty, but it's not going to be there, because I need to play like her vocals, because it's all coming in from just be very precise at the ending part. So If I didn't know better, I would say it almost sounds like the chords for a certain Roger Waters song. Right? Probably accidental. So pretty. Okay, I think I have all of it pretty much. Okay, let's see. Can I? I wonder if I can make it all appear on like a single screen. Probably can make it low, like less large. Nope, probably can't. Okay, let's I'm going to play it once again with the whole no, let's play it without the music. Just try to play it one more time from scratch. Okay. So we have like broken down pretty much everything, wrote down most of it. So now, do I even remember it? Yes, right? I'm just noticing it now for the first time. Okay, so now I'm remembering the beginning has this like breathing sound, like. So let's see. Ah, why am I so flaky? I'm already angry at myself. I'm seeing the things, I'm seeing them too late. Okay, I have to do it slower. Okay, not so bad. Whew, okay, I did not mute myself, so I probably like was breathing heavily throughout all of it, so that's a bad thing. But it's not so bad. Okay, I feel like I was kind of like chasing after some of the things that I didn't remember. I couldn't look at the lyrics at all. Like usually what I would have in front of me is like I would print it out and have the two pages. Not sure if it's like important enough for this. This is almost like prep work, right? So like if I did my work right on this part, like so far, technically it means I would be able to like go like do 1, 2, 3, 4 takes of this, and one of them I'd like enough, like playing from start to finish, until I have a version that I like. Okay, let's see what I missed. So intro, okay, verses were kind of okay. I found it hard to play this like it's kind of confusing because I'm playing like the "Someone Stole the Moon Tonight, Took My Light," but I'm playing this like, which is the part of the piano, but it's all piano, so it's a bit confusing. And I forgot to do the bye again. Part was okay. I honestly didn't remember what happened on this part. Promise me you'll help me again. I'm so broken from this hurry. Okay. And all the world behind also, I was gonna like, sit in the storm. Okay, nothing interesting in between these parts. Okay, so it's just like playing the second verse. Supposed to do like, I didn't write anything down here, so I was really trusting myself to remember those like breaks. Okay, this is like for the power vocals. I tried to do like octaves, but I don't think it's actually so nice. I'm not sure. Maybe yes. Okay. You know what? I'm going to try it like again from the top, because who knows? Maybe that would be a great take that actually works. Probably not. And if not, then our work here is wasted. But my God, squash, Asurkun, Sam, and thank you so much. And Izzard, thank you for proposing ideas and supporting in the chat. It means a lot. I've never done this kind of thing in front of an audience. Try to forget about the stream slash recording. What? Ah, what? No, I will never forget. Yeah, I'm not sure. Okay, let's try this like one more time. Worst case, I'll just like sit down another time and play it a full take. So my plan is now to do like this, and then afterwards we'll do a break, and then we'll come back and do one round of requests. So it's like more like a regular stream at the end. Yes. Okay, now I'm going to mute myself for this. Okay, see, this is what happens. Now all of the ideas and all of the things I remembered, they're all like coming in at the wrong place. Even though I have the lyrics, but I'm like literally like I'm kind of looking all blurry at them. Let's try again. Thank you. Okay, not so bad this version. Yeah, I forgot. Okay, so I forgot this part. Like this part. But it's pretty good, it's pretty decent. Might be just good enough to put it up on YouTube as like the end of the live learned version. I feel like it's gonna be a cool thing. Okay, so I feel that was like a good the ending needs to linger. I mean, her ending, let's see.
לראות תמיד אתה משאיר לי אור אחד קטן
Yeah, it kind of was a bit more abrupt on my version.
קטן
What do you say?
לראות
Let's spend like 3 more minutes just trying to do another. So, what I know from going into studios to record stuff, which again I haven't done in a very long time, but when I used to do recordings, what I usually had to as an experience is like kind of you do a take and you say, okay, I feel like this was okay, but I probably can do better. Then you do another and it's not good. Then you do another and it's not good. Then you do another and it's not good. Then at some point you kind of go back to the first take and say, it wasn't so bad. I should just use that one. So I'm afraid it always can happen. You think it will be at like better and better, but sometimes like when you have to do it like again and again, especially if it's like one take, you just get more annoyed or you forget another part. So when I do like a video of myself trying to play like a whole song, and when I had to like cut it, I just had like a bunch of takes where it's like enough. Or me playing like 1 more minute and then like again and like always like be angry and disappointed. Pure qualities of a musician. Okay, but we'll do 1 more take now. Okay, so we'll see what goes on. Now, a lot of it is like already in my head, so I don't have to look at the page. So hopefully it will be better. Let's see. Okay, but you know what? I think we're going to switch out of lab mode for this one. Ta-dam! Okay, let's go into full screen. Oh, and kind of fix where everything is. Huh. Okay. Yes. Hello, Big Frankie. You know that's my nickname. Okay. Great. Let's do 1 more take of this. Oh, should we do like the. Should we keep this camera? Somewhere? Somewhere where it's less confusing? I wonder what I should do with it. Hold on. Show. Is there any way I can like transform it to be like mirrored? Flip horizontal. No, that's not good because now the left hand is where the right hand is. Holy moly! Okay, now I have to say thank you so much, Astrakun, for resubscribing for 11 months. It's so unfair that I don't have the alerts now because that's amazing. And thank you so much for the upgrade to your third tier. It's amazing. Much appreciated. So I doing like my own alerts. Whee! Or something. Thank you for that. Okay, let me cancel whatever I did here. And should I keep this here in the corner? Let's keep this. Okay, let's do 1 more take of this and then we'll go back. And Izzard, thank you so much for the resub. Oh God, 14 months of supporting the stream and this is like a hype train which is completely not on screen. How embarrassing. Let me do this 1 take. Jesus Christ. As we all Jews say all the time, of course. I want to do this 1 take and then everything will be back to normal. Yeah, you think it should be larger? Is this better? Wait, let's do this. You'd leave out the corner? Wait. So, should I keep it or not? What do you say? I'm not doing a poll, but just like let me know if you think this is okay or if it's ruining the whole image. Keep. Okay, I got 2 keeps. what not keep. You can, but I feel like it's confusing when it's like just a front look. So I'm keeping it. Hopefully it won't bother anybody. Okay, let me do one more take of this. Forgot to kind of count how it feels. She has the breathing noises there, so I don't. So let's try again. It's exactly what always happens. Now I get too like in my own head about it. Okay, I'll try it one more time afterwards. No more takes of this song, and just play regular requests after a break. Okay, let's go. Yeah, I'm going to do my own noises. Ah, bad choice of where to play it. Okay, breathing exercises. Nose out through the mouth. Out through the nose. Out through the mouth. All right. You know what? That was a pretty good take. That was a pretty good take. That was like pretty good. No, pretty good on this one. You know what? I have now decided to re-enable the interruptions. Oh, here's everything again. And let's kill the second camera, I think. Right? Or should we keep it? Maybe we'll keep it for a bit. If I already have the song. Okay, so I'm telling you what. Yes, I haven't opened the list yet. Thank you so much for Oh wow. Look at my hands. Okay. I'm going to take. Yeah, why am I talking?